is Ilke Jan-Miersma and I'm an artist from the Netherlands. And before I start this tutorial, I would like to show you a medium I used to finishing up this piece a little bit faster. Because as you can see, it's quite a big canvas. Most of this is done with oil, so you can imagine if I don't had a medium which would speed up the drying time, it would take me a lot of time to finish this piece. So therefore I would like to show you the medium I use, and it's from Winsor & Newton, and it's called Liquim Original, and it will help speed up the drying time. And that is very useful if you're using, if you paint in oils, and especially on a big canvas like this. It would take me otherwise weeks, and I think maybe months, to finish this up. So that's why I'm using this this product. Well, let's get started with that tutorial. If you are using that liquid medium for the oils, it will also need a drying time about one night, so it will be dry overnight. But before when I start out my painting, I like to work a little bit quicker, and that's also why I'm starting out in acrylic paint. It allows me to work even faster than with the liquid in the oils. So that's one of the reasons I like to start out with the acrylic paint. And also it's I like to start out mapping things when I am starting a painting, and acrylic is very useful for that. And I like to map out things so I can much easier see where things should go, and I start out with the lights and the darks and build from there. So that's why I like to use to start out with acrylic paints, and also it works very well with oil paint, and especially when you are layering much, it yes, those two work perfectly fine together. So that's also why I like to start out in acrylic paint. Like I said, you see me here mapping out things where they should go. And I'm not quite exact in the beginning. I'm just building up my layers and really trying to define where the lights and the darks should go. And I watch the direction where I'm painting in because of the fur. And I must say, this one was a little bit harder for me, because I'm used to painting fur, but that's most of the time it's dry fur. I never ever painted an animal with fur underwater, so that's it's quite different than I was used to, because the fur is wet, and wet fur shows up different than dry fur. You don't see that much hairs, and I had to focus even more on the lights and the darks to get in the shapes like I should. So therefore you really want to watch your reference very closely. If you have a hard time with painting something new, the reference photo is telling you what to do, but you need to trust your reference photo, and you need to trust yourself in what you're seeing. And that's why it's so important that you copy what you see. And that's what was helping me through this process to painting this painting, because it was very new, and it felt almost unnaturally to paint in fur like I had to do here. But yeah, like I said, it was my reference photo that was telling me to do it like this, because yeah, wet fur is need a different approach than dry fur. And I will be making a video on which brushes I do use for making fur, and I hope to make that quite soon. And in that video I will show you the brushes I use to make the fur, and the different fur. And I think I have about 5 or 6 brushes I like to use to making fur. And it took quite some time to get the right brushes for making the right fur. And there are many different brushes that you can use, but I found about 5-6 brushes that are very helpful, and they are not that expensive. So in the beginning I thought I needed one magical brush for making fur, but it appears that you don't need one brush, but you need a few brushes, and also that's very personal in which brush you like the most. But like I said, I will make a video soon about talking about that a little bit more than I do here. And here you see me starting in oils. I'm laying in the first layer of oils over the background. It's still not the right color, but I'm building up that color, and this blue is quite transparent, so I obviously need more layers there. And I'm here filling in painting over the acrylics with oils. I'm choosing my colors a bit carefully now. I'm building up to those last layers, and I'm using quite some green here because of the reflection of the water on the fur, on the white fur. And white fur may seem white, but most of the times it's almost every time it's not pure white, but always it's tinted with some colors around the subject. And in this case it was the water, so I painted it slightly green and blue. And in the beginning, if you're starting out drawing or painting, it can feel quite overwhelming, noticing the different colors on the white fur and how to get in the shapes as you wish they would be. But that will come with experience. So if you're starting out, don't give up. Just try to practice as many as you can. I'm now painting for and drawing for almost 4 years now, and I try to practice every day, at least for 10 minutes. So I will grow and basically learning and trying out new things as many as I can. And it will get you there, but it needs some time. So don't give up, and be disencouraged, but try to continue your drawing and try to practice. And here you see me painting in that fur where I was talking about earlier in this video. It was quite hard. I was basically more blending my different colors here than making fur. And like I said, that was some getting used to, because I wasn't used to that. I'm used to painting in a fur that you can see, dry fur. And here I was blocking in different colors, and don't try to lose my shapes, and also trying to paint something in focus, yes, like his head, and more details here, details on the nose and on the head, and the rest of the body was slightly more out of focus. So that was where I was focusing on. Here you see me putting another layer on the background. Now it's getting a more richer color, and I think this is the last layer on the background. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, I think this was the last one. And so I will be almost painting in the bubbles. Oh, here I'm starting the bubbles. And for that I'm using a technique of Lisa from Lockery Fine Art. And yeah, it seems more difficult than it actually is. It's obviously needs a little getting used to, but yeah, the technique she's using is very, very nice. It's making nice bubbles, and you can use them as for water bubbles or for air bubbles, like I do in the water now. And what you wanna watch is that you always letting some color see through where you're painting in a bubble. So you don't fill the bubble up with one of with the two colors, but you always let something see through what's behind that bubble. Here I'm basically making a sort of mesh. It's it's sort of different shapes, bubbles, and some of them are defined a little bit more as a bubble, but the most of that was quite messy, and I tried to give the general feel of bubbles, because the polar bear was falling into the water, of jumping into the water, and there were quite some bubbles together as a group, so I couldn't paint them in one by one, but try to make the suggestions of a lot of bubbles there. And now I'm pulling some bubbles forward to give the three-dimensional feeling to the piece. And I'm using a soft brush to blending the colors. I'm using white and black and blending those colors. And like I said earlier on, I'm trying to let some background see through. So also here on a polar bear, it gives me a more three-dimensional look if I paint in the bubbles like that. And later on I will come back to those bubbles and tinting them with the colors I used on the water to give them a little bit more give more the feeling that they are on the water and they are reflecting the color of the water. So I also like to put in many different shapes of bubbles, and try not to make the same bubble over and over again, because that will not look very naturally. So I try to make different shapes of into the bubbles as well. And they are some of them are a lot bigger, some of them are very small. Like you see me here doing some little ones. They are the furthest away, and I noticed that these ones were quite smaller than the rest of the bubbles. And I'm tinting a few bubbles, making in the last ones, and here is the finished project. And I like to notice that it can be very hard to get nice photos if you put on the furnace. So before you furnace your painting, please make the photos and then apply your furnace, because otherwise it will be very hard to make good photos from your artwork. Well, thank you for watching. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. And if you like my work or my videos, please subscribe to my channel. I would really like that. And for now, I hope to see you at my next video. Bye bye.